on this renewal, Kit and I will talk about that we're trying to talk you into fighting against the TPP. So my name is Leslie Harris. I wear many hats because I'm ADD and OCD. And so my therapy is doing everything. So I coordinate the Code Pink chapter here and Veterans for Peace and the North Texas Light Brigade and something else. And I work with the Dallas Peace Center and the North Texas Civil Rights Project, which how many of you have heard of the North Texas Civil Rights Project? Okay, good. If you haven't heard of it, please go to our website or our Facebook page and sign up and tell everyone you know about it. If you have a civil rights problem that you think needs litigation, possibly, there's a number that you can call, and lawyers will get together and take a look at it, and it's to serve the underserved. If you have friends who can't afford a lawyer, and they have a civil rights claim, have them check it out.
Oh crap, I got two plays.
Take it back.
Use your school teacher voice. Clap once if you can hear my school teacher voice. All right, now. Oh, good. Now first with the kids.
Oh, now.
Veterans for Peace is hosting this event, and we have many co-sponsors. Raise your hand if your group is co-sponsoring. Joyce isn't here.
I'm not.
I should make Jim for you.
Kit is representing.
What's the TPP? I'm representing Popular Resistance and Expose the TPP. All my Lord.
So please go there, and we're kind of doing this as part of a national campaign by Flush the TPP to raise awareness. Well, and you all read the thing, so you know why you're here. Veterans for Peace originally wanted to host this concert by David Robig. David, stand up and wave, everybody. How many of you have never yet heard David give a concert? Oh, you're in for a big treat. It's going to be a fun ride. Our president, Tom Madden, president of our local chapter of Veterans for Peace, he and I were planning this together, and he really, really wanted to do this and was excited about it. But on a couple days before Christmas, he was hit by a drunk driver, and he died on Christmas Day. So I know that's terrible, and I didn't mean to bring the level down, but we really, really miss him. And so this event is in his honor. He would have loved to have been here. And I think probably every event we ever have, again, will be in his honor. How many of you knew Tom?
What was his last name?
Tom Madden. Yeah. And he was new to the movement. He was a Vietnam veteran, two Purple Hearts. He was on disability for Agent Orange, something to do with Agent Orange. He went religiously to PTSD group therapy at the VA. And he really had it. The Vietnam veterans kind of, if they're going to deal with it, they dealt with it. And he was really one of the strongest people I've ever known. And he had, 2 years ago, he got really sick, and he had to have a double lung transplant.
Whoa.
So he had the double lung transplant, and you can imagine what it is to go through that. And he had, worked his way through that, and he told me, he said, I had a new lease on life, and I realized about, what was important in life, and I wanted to do something really important. So I looked around for veterans organizations, and the only one I could find that, all the veterans organizations do good work. They help veterans with PTSD, and mostly they help with getting VA benefits and stuff like that. But he said, I wanted to be part of an organization that did the really important thing, which was stop wounded veterans from being created. I wanted to stop the war.
Yes.
Let's hear it for Stop the War. So, hi, Gary. You're in front.
I look at the cat.
So, anyway, Veterans for Peace, if you don't know it, please look it up online. It's veteransforpeace.org. And if you know any veterans that you think are want to work for peace and justice instead of just helping wounded warriors, we're always looking for people. It's a great organization. And we miss Tom, but we're really glad that he had started to get this together. Anyway, I'll post something about Tom so you can see how cool he was. He was just, if you looked up stand-up guy in Webster's Dictionary, there was a picture of Tom. So I just wanted to kind of dedicate this to him. So I'm an associate member of Veterans for Peace, and the reason we decided to host this and include the TPP thing in it, you kind of might think, well, what do veterans have to do with TPP? Well, I'm going to read an excerpt from this article from the World Socialist website, and it's called TPP, A Step on the Road to War. Mm-hmm. And, a whole lot of things, like environmental things, Veterans for Peace always shows up there because the U.S. military is the biggest exploiter of fossil fuels on the planet.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
You know what I mean? So, don't separate us out from the rest of the deal. It says, and I'm just reading a little excerpt out of the middle of it.
Yeah.
The claim that the TPP is a quote-unquote Pacific deal and a major advance for free trade is absurd on its face. It has been specifically designed to include China, the world's largest economy. The insistence that free market principles must apply within the domestic economies of member states was aimed at making it impossible for China to join because of the critical role played by state-owned enterprises within its economy. The foundation of the TPP is not free trade, but an alliance between the U.S. and Japan, the world's number one and number three economic powers respectively, to weaken China and create the conditions for reducing it to semi-colonial economic status. This objective is proceeding hand in hand with the military encirclement of China under the Obama administration's pivot to Asia. How many of you have heard of the Asia pivot? Yeah, it sounds innocuous, but you know what it means.
It's a dance move.
Exactly. Good point. There's going to be a song about that.
Oh, good. Okay.
So, pivot to Asia, in preparation for a war, should be considered necessary. However, one of the key problems confronting the U.S. has been the close economic ties between China and the countries of Southeast Asia. Washington has sought to overcome this obstacle by stoking up tensions over long-running territorial disputes between China and its Southeast Asian neighbors and the South China Sea. The TPP develops this strategy on the economic front. So there's a military pivot, Asia pivot towards China, and there's an economic pivot. And this article goes on, and I'll post it on the event site, but the last sentence says ends with, the TPP is a significant step towards the eruption of World War III. So that's why Veterans for Peace cares about the TPP. And we have many other groups that care about the TPP and want to work to stop it. There's a vote going on in Australia, or no, New Zealand on the 4th on the TPP. And after that, it's up to Congress here, so we really need to work on it. And Kit Jones has been working like endlessly against the TPP, and she's our local expert. So if you want to know anything about the TPP, ask Kit. And are you a local expert?
I'm not claiming to be an expert, but I'm with Sierra Club, and we're working very closely with labor very strong partnership to try to kill the TPP.
Yeah, and we're so excited you're here because we wanted to use this event to kind of get people together, and we'd like to sort of form a coalition, much as we did the ALEC coalition, of groups in our area to get together and really fight together against the TPP in our North Texas area.
Yay!
Hope I can put the Sierra Club down, and any other of your groups, if you can, you know, speak for them, or you can get a representative to let us know. We'd like to get, you know, groups signed up so that we can work together and have some numbers and share everything that we know. Because, you know, it's a very complicated thing, so we really want to get it out there to the public, because it's, you know, and I think I put in the description of the event that it's going to affect everyone everywhere. And it really is like, it's our future, the future of our planet, and our children and grandchildren's future. So I'm speaking to the choir. But anyway, I would like to bring up Kit. She's going to tell us a little more, and we have a couple of speakers. David, if you'd like to come up and say something, I'll put you on the list, and just be advised. We asked a couple labor people to come. I don't know. So if you know any labor, well, Daryl's here. Daryl, do you want to say something?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, so we'll put Daryl on the list. And anybody else here from labor? Daryl will tell you why it's a big deal.
Is her painter here?
No.
I can speak for her because we work together.
Yeah. Okay. Who wants to go? Let's save you for last, Kit.
Okay.
Daryl, do you want to come up here? Because we like to share why everyone's group. You know, everybody gets so involved in their own special interest group. These things affect everybody. It's all one big thing. And I think we all know what it is, but we'll see here. Daryl Sullivan.
My name's Daryl Sullivan. I've been a member of Teamsters Local 745 for 32 years. In Grand Prairie, I worked in a factory for 30 years that was shut down for a job that went to China. Personally, it hit me and my family. I mean, it wasn't theoretical or somebody else. It was us right here tonight was affected by this. And I was fortunate enough to remain a Teamster member, and I now work at Yellow Freight. But after 30 years of working in a factory, so this is part of what it means to labor is jobs. We know that the capitalists, that the CEOs, the head of these corporations are going to use this as an excuse to find cheaper labor. There's no question about that. We know what NAFTA has done, and we know this is just going to be NAFTA on steroids. So the teachers are very interested in this issue and trying to protect good paying jobs with good benefits, with pensions. And I think all of us here today know that that's going away. And if we don't stand up and fight for that, if we don't take to the streets, if we don't tell our neighbors and our relatives and everybody we know that our very livelihoods are at stake, if we don't find a way to stop these type of agreements. So.
Thank you, Jeff. I didn't know at the time that's what it was. It totally was.
Wow.
Would you like to come on up?
Thank you. I'm David Griggs. I wear a lot of hats. Some of you know me as a Democratic Party activist, as a Sierra Club environmental activist. But lately I have been working together with Herb, and if he comes in, he can speak as well. Herb Keener of CWA. The Sierra Club in Texas has a very close partnership with labor, with the FL-CIO, and particularly with the local CWA union in what has been called as the Blue-Green Alliance. And so one of the things that we're working on is try to defeat the TPP and other trade agreements of similar ilk. If you have followed this closely, many of you have, in addition to the labor concerns that Daryl mentioned, there's also some very secretive negotiations that went on for quite a while before this thing actually came out. And inside the agreement that we now know, because it's been made public, there are secret tribunals that can be held. There are certain groups and organizations that can get together within the TPP rubric and basically make decisions that do not necessarily favor the public or people who are victimized by environmental disasters and labor discrepancies as well. And so the problem with this, number one, is the way in which disputes are settled is something that we cannot allow it to continue. And it's the same thing, we knew it, you know, all along, that once the secret stuff came out, that it would be bad, and it's as bad as we could have expected. You know, all these agreements like NAFTA and others have similar provisions. Not only that, there is they can sue basically governments that don't, you know, agree with them. And we've seen that in NAFTA. You know, finally the president comes out and denies the Keystone pipeline. And then we see TransCanada suing the United States for the loss of business opportunity for billions of dollars.
Yeah.
Right, exactly. You know, it's like lost opportunity damage. Yeah. As if somehow we owed it to them, you know, to have put in their pipeline.
Yeah.
So that's one thing. Another thing is the problem of the proliferation of the extraction of fossil fuels that will no doubt occur if this Trans-Pacific Partnership becomes the law. If you think now that there's a great proliferation of oil and gas developments, just wait. Because here's what's going to happen. Right now we have restrictions on the export of liquefied natural gas. That will all change. And there will be such a demand for liquefied natural gas in other parts of the world that this craze to frack will continue. It's bad enough now. It's somewhat subdued because the price of fuel is down. But the future is bad. So those of you who are concerned about climate change need to understand that with the passage of the TPP, it's going to be a horrible effect on climate change, because we will continue to extract these fossil fuels from the ground, which will contribute to the CO2 to the atmosphere. So in addition to the serious labor concerns that Daryl mentioned, there are serious climate implications as well. So that's why we need to work together to try to kill it.
Thank you. I'm going to pass this around again in case somebody missed it, stand up. And I hope that if you see your name on here and you'd like to get involved, stay involved in the anti-TPP movement, put a little, you know, frowny face TPP. Okay, who's next? I saw Gary coming. Gary.
Yeah.
Come on over. Where's Fred?
By the way, I'm going to do this. Hi, everybody. For those who may not know me, I'm Gary Stewart. I'm a native Texan, and I'm the local chair of the local chapter of System Change, Not Climate Change. We're the Eco-Socialist Coalition for the United States and Canada. And our main goal is to move away from the economic system that we currently have, just call it capitalism, where the only goal is profit, no matter what, the consequences. And we're totally down on fighting against the TPP because it's totally, completely anti-democratic. It's anti-democracy. And it's corporate control of all forms of government, from local up to international. The tribunals that David was talking about will overturn any authority, local, state, national. They're not beholden to the current legal systems that we have. And all their only goal is profit. Doesn't matter who gets poisoned, how many children die. And we see it here in our own state. Not this past week, but the week before. Some of us had to go through the talk dog and pony show again over the Texas Commission on Environmental Quality. Not that is totally controlled by oil and gas industries and their interests. And some of them finally had it. And I guess this is my main point. Some of us have been doing this for years. Some people have been fighting the TPP, which is controlled by corporate interests, gas and fossil fuels, that they were trying to submit to the EPA a clean air plan that was not a clean air plan. They had no reductions in emissions, and people finally had it. They pretty much use F-bombs to say, screw you.
As reported in the Dallas Morning News.
What?
As reported in the
Dallas Morning News. Oh, I didn't see that. And I guess that's what my main point is. We have to say no to the game. We have to say no to being polite. We have to say no to that and take over the process wherever, whenever, and however we can, nonviolently. And so we need to go to the streets, as other people have said. We need to go to hearings and let them know what we think, but also condemn the dog and pony show that these, quote, hearings are. Show up, but put them on trial. So system change, like climate change, we worked with the Dallas Sierra Club to have the March on Climate Justice. And we had about 200 people there in freezing cold weather. But that was only the beginning. We are going to be working to create a movement, a coalition, or a campaign to get the city of Dallas and hopefully the other municipalities to start addressing seriously global warming and climate disruption. But along with that is also working for economic justice. If there is no economic justice, there cannot be environmental justice. There cannot be racial justice. And so these are our goals, and that's why we're going to be working with you guys. So we're going to be having our retreat, planning retreat, next month. And I hope some good things will come up out of system change like climate change. And I hope y'all can join us in the fight for economic, environmental justice. Thank you.
Yay!
If anyone in the room isn't registered to vote at your current address, the deadline to vote in the primary is February 1st. I'm a deputy registrar. I can register you on the spot. And now is the time to do it. So catch me sometime before I leave.
You got like 24 hours, so better catch you now. So.
Bernie!
Okay, and hey, so I think
yeah. Can I just say one thing to follow up what Gary said? Climate change march that we had was just an incredible combination of progressive groups in our community. The Sierra Club, and I know Gary helped us with it, but we had over 200 people literally on Thanksgiving weekend.
Which is a big deal for Dallas.
We actually got Channel 8 there. To cover the march. And so I was just very proud of the progressive groups, not just environmental groups, but we had LGBT, we had human rights groups, we had your group, everybody was there.
Because we all have to breathe the air and drink the water and live on the planet. So, we all need to get together and kick butt. For us, Sarah, for Caleb would say, yeah, kick ass! So, okay, I think it's time for Kit. Kit knows everything about the
people.
So.
Well, not everything.
Jones, come on up.
It's 5,400 pages after all, so.
5,400.
I probably
see,
missed
5,400
pages.
Probably
missed a thing or two.
Thank you, Kit.
Yay. Thank you. Thank y'all so much for being here. I just get chills listening to everything. I'm really happy to be with you all. Okay. I've got just a brief statement because there's things that I wanted to be sure and cover, and it's better that I kind of deliver it to you off the page and just out of my head, off the top of my head. But I am first and foremost a private citizen. I'm a counselor and a psychotherapist in private practice. I live and work in Fort Worth. And as an extension of my work, I also have been volunteering with others in two international anti-trans-Pacific partnership groups for the last 4 years. Since I learned about just a small part of what had been leaked out about the Trans-Pacific Partnership, it also has siblings, two siblings. They're called the Transatlantic Investment Partnership. That's for Europe. It's basically trying to do to Europe what they're trying to do with the Pacific right now, what you're just hearing about. And also there's the Trade and Services Agreement, which adds up to 80% of the commerce that's done worldwide. It's hard to comprehend. But so it's a TPP, the TTIP, and the TISA for short. I learned that it had been in the works secretly as of this point today for about 7 years. Here is some of what I know about them. This also applies to all of them, all three of those that we were just talking about. And by the way, Ron Kerr, the former mayor of Dallas, is a former U.S. trade representative. He's the one for the entire country who represents us in these negotiations. One person, not elected, appointed by Barack Obama. He was in college at Harvard Law with Barack Obama. Just FYI. So he said that they were keeping it secret because the more people who knew, the less they would like about the TPP, and it would become so unpopular it could never become law. Each public leak of its provisions has proved him right. We are something. The TPP and its siblings were written without the permission of one single elected United States official. Instead, they were written by 600 multinational corporate executives and lawyers in secret meetings over that 7 years, approximately. So they're treaties written by and for transnational corporations. The writing of the treaties by the U.S. Constitution and our legal system is the sole responsibility of the U.S. Congress, which alone has the authority and responsibility to write treaties. Congress was recently duped into surrendering their responsibility and authority for writing these particular treaties to corporations and lawyers. This was made possible by the Supreme Court Citizens United decision, you can remember that, that corporations have the same rights as flesh and blood people. We must face the fact that our political system has been corrupted to the point that corporations have literally bought and paid for many of our officials, both elected and appointed, in the Congress and the Supreme Court. That is how we have come to have TPP, TTIP, TISA, nearing votes in Congress. Treaties that not one elected representative nor senator has had anything whatsoever to do with writing. Those votes must not happen. The TPP is 5,400 pages long. It's only six of the 30 chapters involve trade whatsoever. The other 25 chapters are corporations slicing, dicing, wheeling, dealing, and stealing everything that ordinary humans need to live. Everything. Since Ed Schultz was taken off the air by MSNBC, you haven't heard anything true about it in mainstream media. Because MSNBC is owned by one of those 600 multinational corporations who wrote the TPP. I hear now that he's actually on Russia Today, so I'm very happy to hear that. I worked for and gave money to the campaign to elect Barack Obama President of the United States, so I cannot fathom nor explain why he is so bent on ramming the TPP through Congress as his legacy in his final months in office. This is a huge disappointment to me and to my many colleagues in the anti-TPP, TTIP, TISA groups that I have had the pleasure of working with over the last 4 years, many of whom also supported his election. I'm sure we could raise our hands and a lot of us would have done that. The president tried to convince Americans during his State of the Union address that the TPP is the best thing since sliced bread because here's the real truth about the TPP. And bear in mind, this is just a snapshot of the biggest, quote, trade deal in the history of the world. The TPP alone applies to 40%, just the TPP. 40% of global trade. Undermining food safety protections by making it harder for countries to adopt regulations such as labeling laws or banning GMOs. Dismantling the Buy Local movement by overturning government laws designed to keep taxpayer dollars in the local economy. Inhibiting access to life-saving medicine by extending monopoly drug patents for big pharmaceuticals. Curtailing internet freedom, which is how we all stay in touch with each other, because you're not hearing anything on the mainstream media now, are you? So, curtailing internet freedom, spurring further financial deregulation, rolling back environmental laws, and much, much, much more. Adversely affecting everyone, everywhere, except for the 1% transnational corporate billionaires who wrote it. I encourage you and all of your, to call your U.S. representative and senators. It seems like a small thing we hear. We're exhorted to do that all the time, aren't we? But this is where it's coming down. The Congress is going to have a decision to make on this. The best case scenario would be if they hear from so many of us that they know that they won't even bring it up. It won't be brought up for a vote. So what we need to be doing is each of us calling our representative and our senators and letting them know that we to stop TPP. Vote no on TPP. And the numbers to call are 202. Thank you. Everybody got these numbers? 202-224-3121 or 202-225-3121. Same number, just 224-225 is the prefix. I also encourage you to look online at the websites flushthetpp.org, popularresistance.org, and ExposeTheTPP.org. Call your representative and your senators weekly. We win when it is not brought up for a vote. Okay.
What's the form that this is taking? I mean, most treaties just require senators to ratify. Why is it that we're
okay? Congress, what happened was this: Congress was duped into giving up their constitutional authority and responsibility for making treaties to the people writing these treaties. Thank you. Yeah, I want to pass those on that side and these on this side.
What is the time frame for this?
When is the vote?
Okay, the vote? Okay.
Whenever they think they have enough.
The president, as Leslie said, the president is going to vote on, he's going to sign the TPP on February 4th in New Zealand. And after that, at any time that he and his cronies think that they can sneak it through, ram it through the Congress, and get it to pass, they can do it after that. I think there's like a somewhere between like a 60 and a 90 day delay. But pretty much any time this year, actually there's talk that they may try to do this during a lame duck session in Congress between the election and the new company.
Conservative politicians because of Obama wants to pass it.
Yeah.
But do you know, like, about our representatives or senators, like in Texas, or about their positions?
There are two representatives relative in Texas who we need a term. Beto O'Rourke in El Paso, and who's the guy in the valley? Ruben Hinojosa.
But the other one, kid, and I don't want it to go unnoticed, Eddie Bernice Johnson has not been with us on this issue.
No.
Eddie Bernice Johnson is not with us on free trade.
Well, and that's a big reason, because we've gone and talked to her several
times. She's been seduced by Obama.
She is 100% with us on every other environmental issue. And the reason is her relationship with Ron Burke. She's the one who got the president to appoint him as trade rep.
She is not with us on free trade.
That's correct.
And the teachers are not going to support her. And this issue is important to us, and she is not with us on
that. That's correct, absolutely, yes.
She may have her reason. She may have a reason, but I have a reason for needing the job, too.
Has Vesey come out?
Absolutely right.
Yes, Mark Vesey is opposed.
Mark Vesey is definitely opposed, yeah. So, yeah, the two, Beto O'Rourke in El Paso, and Ruben Hinojosa in the valley.
But the biggest deal about the TPP, in my opinion, is the way it can undermine all our environmental laws. We can set up all the environmental protections we want, or any other kind of laws that we want. And the TPP comes in with corporate boards and overturns it.
Well, Eddie Bernice's answer to that is very weak. She's not concerned about bad air in Asia, she's worried about bad air here.
Well, she was. You know, she got schmoozed by Obama. He had her in his Air Force One all over Europe. She's just been seduced by Obama. I'm sorry, I don't pull any punches. I just feel it like it is, as far as I know. Yes, ma'am.
What's in it for Obama?
Money, power, who knows?
But he's the president.
And two more questions after this. My belief is that he just was sold out from the beginning.
I think all living presidents have been in.
One more question?
I'm not sure about
that. Is that it?
Bernie's not in favor of it, I don't think.
No. Well, and Hillary, 45 times.
Yeah, I know. She says she's not in favor
the
of
TPP. And when he was surging in the polls, suddenly Hillary was against it.
As soon as she's elected, she'll change her mind again.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Hillary's change of mind was a big move.
Bernie's elected.
Let's listen to Dave.
This is just the beginning. I can tell you guys we have a good dialogue about this, and I'll let you know right now. They're supposed to sign the TPP on Thursday, February 4th, and we are planning. We're going to have an action, and I just posted it on Facebook yesterday. I mean, if anybody see it on Facebook, February 4th, we're going to meet at, I can't remember what time, 5 o'clock outside of Mockingbird Station. And we're going to pass out flyers there. I didn't put this in the Facebook page because the cops will freak out, but a couple of us are going to be dressed as billionaires for the TPP. How many of you are familiar with billionaires? All right. If you would like to join us and be dressed as a billionaire, they'll say we're demonstrating. That's not allowed. We're passing out flyers. It's okay. So we're going to do billionaires for the TPP. Teacher boys. We have our good signs that say, we have clean air and water. We have clean, who needs clean water? We have champagne and stuff like that, So we have fun, and I know where Jeff is, but he's going to be one of our billionaires, I think. Okay, so anyway, look on Facebook for that. I'll post it on the site. Hey, look at—he's playing me out.
Good job, man.
Yay!
I want to say, well, do you get You can call now, everyone, call, and you know what, on the weekend, if, how many of you have never, or no, how many of you have ever called Congress on the 800 number?
Not on the 800, I've called it.
Whatever, if you call now, this is the number in Washington, these 202 numbers are Washington DC, and it's, they're not there, so you can leave a message and you don't have to be intimidated, even though every time you call, a staffer answers and they just ask you what you want to do and you say, tell the congressman to vote against the TPP and they go, thank you. They just keep a tally, it's not intimidating. So if you want to call right now, call now. How many seconds till you're ready, David?
Zero, let's see.
Okay, so now,